Granny's back. I've got all my stuff ready to go crocheting. First of all, my cup of coffee, of course. You see, it's a very funny cup of coffee because on the front side you see the face of the cat. And now, for you fainted-hearted, please don't watch. But for everybody else, see? The butt of the cat. It's this little butt with the tail, and you see all the back. And when you turn your muck around, your beaker, your coffee cup, you see its little face and the ball and gorgeous eyes. Oh, but always has such funny beakers. Well, that's my coffee. So that's ready. Let me take a sip. Perhaps, next time I should pour you a cup of coffee as well. So we can have coffee together. It's so much more fun having coffee together. It's gezellig. So, yeah? Next time, okay? And I've got myself my cookie. It's a penny waffle. A penny waffle. It is so nice. It's a very old-fashioned cookie. When I was a child, I was so pleased when my mom gave me a penny waffle. It is all memory lane. I love it, penny waffle. And I have cut myself a crochet needle. 2.75. That's a funny number. Usually, let me eat my cookie. Usually, you crochet with 2.5 or 3 millimeters, and now it's 2.75. Well, that's the one I could find for this beautiful cotton from Durable. And you can crochet it with 2.5 or with 3, whatever you want. Let me see, over here. Can you read that? It's small letters, but you can crochet it with that. And I found just in the middle, 2.75. I thought, hey, it's a nice and golden crochet needle, so I will use that one. And what are we going to crochet? Well, something very old-fashioned. I've got an old-fashioned cookie, and I've got some old-fashioned coffee and old-fashioned yarn, because Durable is a very old-fashioned brand of yarn, and it is very modern as well these days. Durable Coral. It is, let me see if I can read it. I've got my glasses on, so it says 100% cotton. Mercerized. Well, that means that when they were making, they're doing something technical with it, and now it's nice and shiny and soft and smooth. It is a gorgeous yarn. And in one skein, you have 50 grams, and it's 125 meters. And I know, let me tell you, I know they have got small balls as well. And they are 25 grams, or 20, I think 25. I'm not quite sure, but they do have small balls of yarn from the Durable Coral. It is gorgeous. And what are we going to make? We are going to make cabinet edges. Yes, in Dutch it's katrantjes. I looked it up in Google Translate to say it right, a cabinet edge. It's very old-fashioned and really suitable for granny. And what is this color? Let me see. Ivory. You see, it's ivory. And ivory, I think, is a very old-fashioned color. ivory comes from the elephants, you know, the big elephant teeth. And luckily, echt, really, heavenly, it is forbidden. Those elephant teeth, that ivory, it's forbidden. They are not allowed to kill any more beautiful elephants. But we can crochet with the same gorgeous color, of course. And I love it, they are not allowed to kill elephants because elephants are such a great animals. Really, they are. They are much bigger than Vonnis cats. Yes, much bigger. They will not nick my cookie here on the table. Because they don't fit on the table. The table would collapse if an elephant came to sit on it. Even a baby elephant. This table wouldn't hold it. I'm not going to show you because then my coffee goes all like that. And then we have an accident. Last time I had an accident, I think I turned off the camera, so you didn't see it, but I spilled coffee on the nice tablecloth, that green one, you know, so I had to put it in the washer, but it's hot weather, and that's okay, so it's dry in a jiffy. Really, you put it outside on the rack, you know, on the wash rack, and then you leave it flat to dry, and boy, in an hour it's dry, so Fonne will never know. But I didn't put it on the movie, so she will not know that I spilled coffee, because it's a waste, it's a liquor abuse, yes. Spilling coffee is liquor abuse. Let's drink some. That's far more wise to drink coffee. But I think it's time to crochet. I will get my yarn and my needle. Oh, I've got my yarn and my needle. But I'm going to make a loop, etc. And then we are going to crochet a beautiful cabinet edge. I love it. Here is my yarn, my durable coral. And I'm going to make a loop on my hook. Just like that, very easy. And we are going to crochet change. We are chaining. We are chaining. And how many do you need to make? Well, after my sip of coffee, I am going to chain groups of four. For the length that I want for this edge. And I have measured Vonnis precious things cabinet. And there are two shelves in there. So I have to make two. And those shelves are 85 centimeters. So I have to make two big ones. And I am crocheting single change. I'm going to crochet change in groups of four as long till I have 85 centimeters. So I'm going to count. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Well, that's not 85 centimeters, so 4 again. 1, 2, 3, and 4. It's not 85 centimeters. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Well, now I have 12 of those change, but it's still not 85 centimeters. But let me give you a tip. If you want to make more of those edges for the same shells in your cabinet, then you have to count your stitches so you can make them as big as the other one. Because if you make it four less or more, it's going to be smaller or bigger, and that's not what you want, of course, unless the shells aren't the same size. But if you want to make more of one size, then please count your change. I am going to do that as well. I've got 12, and I'm going to count till I am at 85 centimeters, and I will have my coffee and my cookie, and I will be back when I have 85 centimeters and counted my change. You must make groups of four, and then I will be back. So I have chains, 160 chains, just like that. And I fitted it on the shelf and it fits. So this is enough. 160 is for me enough for the cupboard of fun. So when you have enough and it is wide enough for yourself, then you have to add two chains. Two. You do two more. Remember, this chain should be dividable by four. You have to crochet groups of four. And now you add two more. One and two. And now I'm going to zoom in. No, the other way around, Granny. Like that. And I'm going to put some juice on the camera, because the battery is almost out. So now I have to put some juice in it. It likes coffee, don't you like? Think so? So there's the juice. Now it gets electricity again. Well, that was technical, so I need my coffee. Granny is technical too. Well, we have added two chains, remember? And now we are going to single crochet in each chain, starting in the second chain from the hook. But to make a nice upper side of the cabinet edge, I am going to single crochet in the back of the chain. When you feel it, the front has all these V's and it is smooth and soft. And when you feel the back, you feel all kind of bubbly stuff. And in those bubblies, we are going to crochet. And then we are going to crochet in the second from the hook. And the first one you will find right after your thread that comes out of the stitch, there is the first one. And you're going to skip that one and you're going to the second one. You see, here is that bubble, right in the middle of the stitch. And you put your needle under it and help it with your fingers so you cut that bubbly thing on your hook. And now you yarn over, pull it through, and you can make a single crochet like that. And you are going to do that in each of those bubbles. You see those bubbles here in the middle? You are going to put your needle in it, and one time it goes more easy than the other time. You can help it with your fingers and you single crochet in it. You see, every one. And when you are at the end, you should have all your chains done. So I should have 160 single crochets plus one. You make one more. So if you started with a chain of let's say 100 chains, and then you had to add two, so you have 100 chains, that will be 100 single crochets, and then you count one more. You should have 101. If you made 30 chains, you should, and then you add two chains, you should have 31 single crochets. Always one more than the chains you change, excluding those two at the end you add. I hope I am a bit, so you can understand it. But you see me crocheting in the back loop, just like that, and I will show you why. Look, this is what we crocheted, and when you turn it around, there's a nice edging. And because you are going to hang it like this, the downside will be upside, and then you see those gorgeous V-stitches. It is just a little bit more, yes, nice. So I am going to crochet my single crochets in the back loop of all those chains, and then I will be back. And if you say, well, Granny, it is way too difficult for me, then you don't. I'm sorry, I think I've got a cold. But then you don't, then you just put your needle in your chain and crochet a single crochet. That is okay too, but you won't have that beautiful edge at the top. But that's okay. If I did it, I think Fonna wouldn't mind, but she would take my crochet work and put a row of single crochets on top of it, so then you have on top still those beautiful V-stitches, but you have to crochet another row. Well, I can crochet in those bubbly things on the back of the chain, so that is what I am going to do. Going to pour myself another cup of coffee and finish my cookie, because I didn't finish it yet, and watch some TV in the meantime, and then I will be back when I have done all those chains with a single crochet in the bubbly thing on the back of a chain. You see, just like that, and I help it with my finger. I pull the loop like that. I put my needle in front of it, and then I pull the loop with my finger on my needle. And that works for me. So, give it a try. Really, you should. It isn't that difficult. See? Like that. It goes a bit slower than just single crocheting, but this is gorgeous. Fonna is going to love the surprise. Really, she will. So I'm at the end of my chain. You see, all those beautiful single crochets and the beautiful V-stitches at the bottom of it. Because I single crocheted in the back loop of the chain, the bubbly thing, you know. So I've measured it again. I held it to the side of the shelf and shelf, not shell, shelf, and it's a good size. So now we are going to do row two. And it's simple, we are going to make one row of double crochet. So I chain one to bring up the yarn and I turn my work like that, all the way around. And now we are going to give each stitch a double crochet. So yarn over. And in the first one, you are right going to double crochet. So in the first stitch, right over here, I've yarned over, you see, like that, yarn over. And then in the first one, you are going to start with your first double crochet. And if you hear a nice zooming sound, oh, I'm making a mess. When you hear a nice zooming sound, it's the wire. I the blower. I have to turn it on because it is so hot in here. I am sweating myself carrots. Really, I am. It is so hot. And tomorrow it will be even more hot. They say it will be over 40 degrees or something. So please, everybody, drink a lot. And don't be too active. Just sit down and crochet. Just like me. And the children, keep them inside because outside it is way too hot. And give them ice creams. They love ice creams. Really, they do. And not in the sun, because the sun is too hot. Please, take care of the ones you love. So, those were some wise words from an old lady. Huh? So that's what I wish for you. that you take care of the ones you love, as do I. I take care of Fonda's cats. I love those cats, but they have it hard too. So there is lots of fresh water for them, and they are all inside because inside it's not as hot as outside, and they drink a lot. And Krako, the parrot, he's a gray red tail. I spray him with water from a plant sprayer with some fresh water, but not ice cold water because then he will be sick, but with not ice cold water, but not hot water as well. You know what I mean? So he cools down as well. So please, you see me double crocheting in each single crochet, one double crochet until you get to the end, and then you should have as many double crochets as you had single crochets. So please do that, and I will sit in the wind of the blower with my coffee because I have to drink. So coffee, and maybe later I will take an ice cream, but I don't know yet. I have to eat as well, you know. So I had breakfast this morning, and I had some muesli in quark. I don't know English for quark, but muesli with quark, and it was very tasty. I love it. So I am taking care of myself as well, and so should you. So do what is good for you and for the ones you love, and in the meantime, crochet a lot. And I will be back. You see, that's what you get. Double crochets in each single crochet. So, when you are at the end, don't forget your last single crochet. You really need it, so don't forget it. You have to put a double crochet in your last one as well. Oh. Hmm. Ah, I love it. Oh, it's cold coffee. With this hot weather, cold coffee is lovely. They call it ice coffee, and then you pay more. But when you have your usual coffee and you let it sit for a while, it will cool down, and you will have just ice coffee for a cheaper price. Granny is so smart. So, that one is gone. Now, we are going to crochet the next row, and it will be again a row of single crochets. And that will be the last ordinary row, and after that we are going to make some gorgeous stitches. But now chain one and turn your work all the way around, and you are going to make a single crochet in each double crochet. So this is the first one, the first hole. You make your first single crochet, and you go all the way to the end of the row. Each stitch, one single crochet. You see, I didn't even change the names of the stitches. I said a chain and a single crochet and a double crochet. I said it all right. Granny is smart, you know. She really is. You see, one single crochet in each double crochet. And this will be the piece that will go to the edge of the shelf, like that. So, upside down, of course, eh? It's going to hang. So, like that. And then there are going to be a gorgeous row of stitches, or two or three, I don't know yet. Maybe you want to change it yourself, that's okay too, you know. But let me finish this. Just simple single crochets till the end. And then I will be back again. Really, I will. Oh. You see, it's a bit curling, but that's okay. That will be all right at the end. So, let's single crochet. For me, that will be 161 single crochets. and I'm going to watch the Tour de France in the meantime. If you don't mind, and if you do mind, you can watch something else. But I'm going to watch the Tour de France. So, see you in a bit. And then we are going to make those gorgeous, gorgeous stitches. Well, I'm at the end of the row. You see? The last double crochet, I gave a single crochet. And now I still have as much stitches as I began with. The same amount of single crochets. And I've got myself some milk. You see that? This is fun. It's cold milk. I love it. And because the cats nick my milk, I found a beaker, a mug, with a dexel, a lid, and a little straw. So it's nice and pink, and it got all kinds of cactuses, you see, succulents. Funny, so funny, really. Well, we have to crochet. Put the milk aside and let's get serious, because now we are going to make some business. You have to pay attention. You crochet one chain. And then you turn your work. And in the first stitch, over here, let me zoom in so you can see what I do. In the first stitch, you make a double crochet. Like that. You see? And now to make it a little bit more easy, you take a stitch. Oh, I am so happy. Did you see? No, you didn't see. Let me show you. Oh, I threw the mug so like this. And now I only have a couple of drops of milk. I love it. Let me get a little cloth to take it off. So I'm back with some kitchen paper towel. And like that. Ah. Oh. It's all clean again. This is very nice. I love mugs with lids. Really, I do. Yeah. Now we can get back to business. We have crocheted one double crochet. Let me zoom in again. Like that. Oh, you have to stay in the picture. Like that. We have crocheted one double crochet. Now you can see. And then you take your stitch marker and you put it in that stitch. You see, under two loops. Like that. So now you see, you've got a stitch marker in that double crochet. And now you are going to chain two. One and two. Yarn over, and we are going to make a half double crochet in the place where the stitch marker is. So that is why this stitch marker was here, because with the first double crochet it is hard to find. And now you can see it just like that. And we are going to make a half double crochet. So in that stitch, put your crochet needle, yarn over, and pull up a loop. And then you yarn over and you pull through all three loops, like that. That's a half double crochet. And in the same stitch, we are going to make a double crochet. Just like we did over here, double crochet. That's easy, in the same stitch. And I'm going to leave the stitch marker in. I'm not taking it out. And now we are going back to this single crochets. We yarn over and we skip three single crochets. One, two, and three. Skip, skip, and skip. And in the fourth one, we are going to make three double crochets. All in that one single crochet, the fourth one. This is one. And two. And one more. That's three. I always call that the granny stitch, because you use it when you make a granny square. An easy granny square, you put three double crochets in one place. So I call this the granny stitch, and I am granny, so I thought, well, this is nice. And now we are going to chain two again. We are going to make this little bubbly thing. So one and two. Yarn over, and you are going to put your needle in the stitch of the last double crochet you made. Over here, like that. And you pull up a loop. And then you make a half double crochet. So yarn over and pull through all three loops on your hook. And now in the same hole, you're going to make a double crochet. Like that. And you have a nice bubbly thing again. Yarn over. Skip three single crochets, and in the fourth one you are going to make a granny stitch. So skip, skip, skip. And this is the fourth one. And we are going to make three double crochets. This is one. And two. And three. And now you have this. Don't you just like it? I love it. I saw an idea in a book of Vonnegut about edges, and I thought, well, that's a nice idea, but let's change it a bit. So Granny changed it, and now we are going to do it like this. We are going to make a bubbly thing again. So chain two, one and two. Yarn over. And in the stitch of the double crochet you just made, over here you see a little hole. And in that stitch you make a half double crochet. Like that. And then a double crochet. In the same hole. And we can make another granny stitch. Skip three single crochets. Skip, skip, skip. And in the fourth one you make a granny stitch. That's three double crochets. And this is what you do all the way to the end. One. Two. And three. Like that. And then two chains. One and two. And then in the hole of the stitch of the last double crochet you made, you are going to make a half double crochet. So yarn over. In that stitch, go a bit back. In that stitch you make a half double crochet. And a double crochet. Like that. And then you are ready to make another granny stitch. One, two, three skipping. And in the fourth one, three double crochets. This is one, and two, and three. This is easy. Three double crochets. You see? And now you are going to chain two. I'm going to show you one more time. So chain two. One and two. Then yarn over. And in the hole of the double crochet you just made, in that stitch you are going to half double crochet. So yarn over, pull up a loop, yarn over and pull through the three loops that are on your hook. Like that. And then you yarn over and in the same hole you make a double crochet. And then you skip three single crochets. One, two, three. And in the fourth one you make a granny stitch. Do this until you are at the end of the row. Take your time, take a sip of milk, take a cookie, perhaps a sandwich, or an ice cream, or an apple, anything you like. And this is how it's going to hang down, of course. But do this till the end, except the last stitch. I will show you the last stitch. So do this and I will be back at the last stitch. But let me take a sip of my milk, of course. And don't throw it over again. Ah, oh, cold milk, I love it. I'm going to crochet. I'm going to watch the Tour de France again, because it's still not finished. They are, I don't know which etappe they are. I cannot follow that, but I do know they are in the Pyrenees, on their way to the Alps. So that is very nice to see. The nature is gorgeous over there. They cycle around and I don't matter about that, but I love the mountains and the castles and the animals. I love it. I'm going to watch that and you can crochet. And so will I. So, see you in a bit. Well, I am almost at the end. You see, I made my last granny stitch, those three double crochets in one stitch. And I've got four single crochets left. Now, to end it, we make this bubbly thing again. So, two chains, one and two. And then in the opening of the double crochet, just like we did the whole row, a half double crochet, like that, and a double crochet. So that is the same as we did the whole way, but now we are going to end with one double crochet in your last single crochet. So you can skip one, two, three single crochets, and in the last one you make one double crochet, like that. And now I forgot another stitch marker. I will get one. You can watch Doris in the meantime. Look, Doris is over here. And I'm going to get another stitch marker. Because we need one another. So like this. You see? I've got it. So I'm back. And bye-bye, Doris. We are going to crochet again. Like this. You see, because you can stop if you want to, and then you have this as a cabinet edging. But I think it's a bit short. I am going to make more rows of those bubbly things. But you can leave it like that and then you hang it like that on your shelf. It's beautiful. But I want it bigger. So I need another stitch marker to mark the first double crochet I'm going to start with. So chain one and turn your work. I told her you could leave it like this, then you stop, you don't crochet along with me anymore, then you are finished. But I'm going on, and in that first double crochet over here, I'm going to make one double crochet. Just as we started, like that, one double crochet. And in that stitch, I'm going to put that stitch marker I just got. Like that. And now we are going to make a bubbly thing again. So, chain two. One and two. And in the stitch, where your stitch marker is, over here. Oh, that's not very nice. I split the yarn. Did you see that? That's not okay. It's such a beautiful yarn. This is much better. You see, now it's not split. In that hole, we are making the bubbly thing. So, two chains, a half double crochet in the place where the stitch marker is, like that. you can find it more easy, and a double crochet. And you repeat the row. This is a double crochet. Now you skip the bubbly thing and you go to your granny stitch, and in the middle double crochet you make 3 double crochets, just like that, the middle one. And now you make 3 double crochets. 1, 2, and 3. Like that. And now you make a bubbly thing again. So, 2 chains. In the double crochet stitch, a half double crochet, and a double crochet. And this row you can repeat as much as you like. Skip the bubbly thing, go to your next granny stitch, and in the middle double crochet you make 3 double crochets. And you can repeat this row as many times as you like, just to get the height of your cabinet etching as tall as you want to, because now it's going to look like this. You see? Like this. So I am going to crochet this row, and I'm going to keep it in front of the shelf I will stick it to, and then I can see if it's large enough, long enough, I don't know, and maybe I will add another row, or maybe I will not, and then I will hang it up, and when Vanna gets home, she has a surprise. I love it to surprise Vanna. 1, 2, and 3. I will show you one more time. So, 2 chains. In the opening of the double crochet, you make a half double crochet and a double crochet. And then you skip the bubbly thing. This. You skip this one, and in your 3 double crochets, in the middle one, you make 3 double crochets. Your granny stitch. 1, 2, and 3, and then you are ready to make another bubbly thing. You see? So I am going to crochet nice and easy, very relaxed, and then I will be back when I am finished. See? Like this. Oh, like this. It's coming upside down, of course. I'm back. Look, I've been crocheting a lot. Oh, because this is my second one. This is the first one I showed you how to make it. And I've crocheted another one because Vanna has 2 shells in her precious things cabinet. And I wanted to finish this one together with you. I'm so proud of it. I've got myself a new coffee in a nice llama bar mug. Oh, it is such a sweet mug. I think Vanna got it out of an Ila box or something. But it's perfect for her. It's a funny mug, so yes, that's Vanna. Well, let's finish. I've made my last granny stitch. And now I have to make my last bubbly thing. So I'm, don't drop it, granny. It's quite a piece and it falls off the table. Well, let's crochet 2 chains for the last bubbly thing. And then in the stitch of the double crochet you just made, a half double crochet. Like that. Whoopee. And a double crochet. I missed my cookie, but okay, I'm almost done. And now I am going to finish in the stitch on the side where all the other stitches, the bubbly thing, comes out. That's a double crochet, and I'm going to end with a double crochet. And if you want to add another row, you will start with one chain, turn your work and make a double crochet in this one. That's all it is. You see? Like that. And then you cut your yarn with a pair of scissors. You yarn over one more time, pull it through and poof, like that. It's done. And now all you have to do is sew away the tails in the beginning over here and on the end. And then you can hang it in a cupboard, on a shelf, or the cabinet, or just a shelf, whatever you want. And you can make as many rows as you like. Well, I have made two of those. See, this is the first with three of those rows, and this is the second, and I had to start a second ball of yarn. This, but I only took a little bit of it. But with one ball, I could not finish three rows, so I had to take a little bit of a second one. But isn't it gorgeous? It's really old-fashionable, and really Fonna loves it. I'm sure she does. So I'm going to surprise her. I'm going to take first a sip of my coffee. I'm going to surprise her. I'm going to hang it up. I've got some pinny things. I don't know how you call them in English, but they are pinny things with a little head on it and a little colored dopje. Pinaise, but what is the English word for that? I need to study more English. I think it's clear my English is not as good as I thought it was. But it is all right. So, and then you have to decide what is the front and what is the back. Well, you have to hang it up like this, with the bubbly things beneath, below. And then I think the nice side, you can pick for yourself. It doesn't matter. We return the work all the way, and every row we turn the work. So I think it doesn't matter what is the best side, what you like. So I'm going to be technical. Now first I'm going to sew these threads away. That's not that technical. I can do that. But then I have to push those pins with a flat head and a colored bit on it. I have to push them in the shelf, and that's technical. With this neatly on the in between the shelf and the pinny thing. So yes, that's technical. But I can do it. I swear I can. I really can. Really. So that was this tutorial for today. I'm still sweating carrots. It is so hot outside. I did went outside today to go to Fonna, but that was very early in the morning. It was about 8 or something. Half 7. Yes, 7. 8 o'clock, about that. And then it was already hot. So I opened the door when I was still sleeping, and I have the key so I could go in, and I didn't say what I was going to do. So when Fonna left the house, I could crochet for her. Well, that was it for today. I hope you enjoyed it, and that you are going to crochet these for yourself, and perhaps I really enjoyed crocheting such an old-fashioned thing, and perhaps I will crochet some more of those old-fashioned things. You never know, a nice doily or something. Oh, I love doilies, they are so pretty, but I don't promise anything, or I cannot promise, but we will see. I love crocheting this. You see, it is gorgeous. It really is. And it's ready in a jiffy. Really, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 rows. So it depends how long you make it. how much time it takes to make them. But it will be all right. Really, in one afternoon you can crochet two of these easily. So you can watch the Tour de France. Later today they are going to climb the Galibier. That's a French name. I don't know the English name, but the Galibier they are going to climb, and I love the nature, so I'm going to watch that. But first I have to water the cats and feed the plants, and then I'm going to hang these and finish my coffee. And oh, I am so busy these hot days. Well, I see you later, okay? Toodles! I was stupid! Really, I was? I was so dumb! You know what I forgot to tell you? Oh, where you can buy this yarn? Well, Durable doesn't have a web shop, but they do have a website. And I will put a link down below, or I will ask Fanny to do that, to the Durable site, where you can fill in your zip code, your postcode, and then you can find a store in your neighborhood where you can find this gorgeous, gorgeous Durable coral. So I forgot to tell you. Oh, I am so sorry, but I'm happy I didn't finish my coffee yet. So I can have another sip, and then I really, really wish you a very happy day, a blessed day, and please be good to the ones you love, okay? See you later. Toodles.